start the new topic, that is refraction of light. This is the third portion of this chapter. Now, what is the refraction of light? So here, when a ray of light traveling obliquely from one medium to another medium, the direction of propagation of light in the second medium changes, and this phenomenon, it is known as the refraction of the light. Here, take example here, that is a refraction. We take the one glass lamp. We explain that is what is the medium, that is the air medium, glass medium, air medium. So when ray of light is passed through one medium to another medium, so this ray slightly bent away, and this phenomenon, it is known as the refraction of light. Now here, refraction through the rectangular glass lamp. So for that, we take the one cardboard paper, white cardboard paper, and put the glass lamp on the paper and mark it with a pencil, that is A, B, C, D. Press it and mark on hold the four corner, that is A, B, C, D. Okay, it is the glass lamp. Now, here, take the two pins, okay, pin E and pin F. You have to be fixed on one side, that is in A. Now, in opposite side, that is CD side, you have to be see this pin E and F and fix the pin another, that is H and G. You have to fix pin, okay, on the other side in A. Now we move this glass lamp, and with the help of the scale, you draw the line, that is EF line you draw, and another line, that is GH line, you have to be drawn. Now match the point, that is here O and OS, you have to be draw the line. So we obtain the path, that is EF, O, another O'S, G and H line you have to be obtained. So here you draw the perpendicular line, that is N and S, draw the perpendicular line from the point O. Similarly, draw the perpendicular line in opposite side from the point O dash, that is N and S. So we obtain the angle, that is incident angle, reflection angle. Incident angle, reflection angle should be obtained. So from this activity we conclude that here one rays pass from one medium, that is air medium, to glass medium, it slightly bent away from its normal. Similarly, from glass medium to air medium, this is the air medium, glass medium to air medium. So this rays pass from glass medium to air medium is slightly bent away from its normal. Okay, so it will be displaced. You have to draw the line, that is EFO. You have to extend it, okay, with the dotted line. So this distance should be shifted. It is known as the lateral shift. So what is the lateral shift? Here, the ray emerges parallel to the incident ray. The ray is parallel to the incident. This is the incident ray, refracted ray, emergent ray. Okay, so this ray, that is EF ray, is incident ray. The rays travel from glass, that is change the direction. Another medium, glass medium, that is O2 O dash, and this ray is known as the refracted medium. And this ray, that is O dash to H, this ray is known as the emergent ray. So here the ray emerges parallel to the incident ray, parallel to the incident ray, and the light is shifted sideward slightly, that is O and O dash and distance, it is known as the lateral shift. Now laws of the reflection. Incident ray, refracted incident ray, refracted ray and emergent ray. Okay, this ray, all this ray, incident ray, sine angle of incident to the sine angle of refraction. Okay, to both the angles, the ratio of sine angle to the refraction angle is constant should be obtained, and this law is known as the Snell's law. By the mathematical, if you obtain that is sine angle to the sine refraction angle is constant, and this law is known as the Snell's law. And this constant value, it is known as the refractive index eta. It is known as the this constant value is known as the refractive index eta. It is known as the eta. Now, refractive index eta. So it is the eta q1. It means that the refractive index of medium 2 with respect to the medium 1. Again, what is eta 1? That is refractive index of medium 2 with respect to the medium 1. Okay, it is known as eta 1. So the ratio of speed of light in medium 1. So this is the medium 1, air medium. Medium 2 is glass medium. Okay, the speed of light in medium 1 to the speed of light in medium 2 having a different velocity. Velocity is v1. Suppose the air medium, okay, you do incident the ray that is here having the velocity that is v1. When it enters from air medium to glass medium, medium 1 to medium 2, its velocity is changing, that is v2 velocity. Okay, so speed of light in medium 1 is v1 and speed of light in medium 2 is v2. So refractive index with respect to the medium eta 2 1 is v1 upon v2. Similarly, eta 1 2, the refractive index of medium 1 with respect to the medium 2 is equal to speed of light in medium 2 upon speed of light in medium 1. So this is equal to v2 upon v1. So v2 is the velocity in medium 2, v1 is the velocity in medium v1. So if medium 1 is vacuum, suppose this medium 1 is in vacuum or in air, as you know that in a vacuum the speed of light is 3 into 10 to the 8 meter per second. So the refractive index of medium 2 is considered to be with respect to the vacuum. Okay, this is the vacuum medium and this is the glass medium. Okay, so you consider the absolute refractive index. So if medium 1 is vacuum or the air, the refractive index of medium 2 is considered with respect to the vacuum, it is known as absolute refractive index. Okay, and if this is the speed of light in a vacuum or the air, 3 into 10 raised to 8 meter per second, and this is the speed of light in the medium, then absolute refractive index of medium, that is eta n, speed of light in air to the speed of light in medium is equal to c upon v, where c is the speed of light in a vacuum and speed of light in medium, that is v. So eta n is equal to c upon v. And refractive index of the water, that is eta is the refractive index, w means water. The refractive index of water is 1.33. Okay, next topic is refraction by spherical lenses. Now, as you know that the lens is made from the two surfaces. Okay, this is the two surfaces. Okay, there are two types of the lens: concave lens and convex lens. This is the convex lens and this is the concave lens. Now, these both the lenses are made from the two surfaces. So here, a lens has two spherical surfaces. These lenses are made from the sphere. Okay, the center of the curvature, the lens are made from such type of the sphere, and the center of the sphere is known as the center of curvature. Principal axis and imaginary line passing through the center of curvature. Okay, and it is known as the principal axis and imaginary line passing through the center of curvature, it is known as the principal axis. Optical center, this is the O is the optical center. Okay, the center point of the lens, it is known as optical center O. The center point of the given lens, it is known as optical center O. Aperture, the diameter of the lens, the diameter of the lens, it is known as the aperture. So n is the aperture, okay, of the given lens. The diameter of the lens, it is known as the aperture. Principal focus, okay, if all the rays incident toward the lens and after the refraction all the rays meet on the other side at the one point, and this point it is known as the principal focus. It has two focal point, F1 and F2. Now image formation in lens using the ray diagram. So that is the first image, and for convex lens it is a concave lens. So observe that this is the imaginary line, okay, principal focus lines. Now parallel to the one ray, okay, incident the ray parallel to the principal axis, and after refraction the rays will be passes through the principal focus on other side of the lens. While in concave lens also, okay, the rays parallel to the principal axis after the refraction, okay, the rays will be, if you extend it, it will be meet at the principal focus F1. Similarly, other figure B, that is here convex lens, okay, the incident ray passes through the principal axis, the incident ray is passing through the principal axis, after the refraction it goes parallel to the principal axis. Similarly in concave lens, okay, and imaginary line passing through the principal focus, okay, this is the principal focus F2, and after the refraction it will go parallel to the principal axis. Now in third figure, convex lens, okay, incident ray passing through the optical center, this O is the optical center, the incident ray is passing through the optical center, so without any deviation it will be passing, okay, without any deviation it will be passing through the optical center O. Similarly in concave lens also, okay, without any deviation, if a incident ray is passing through the optical center O, without any deviation it will be passed. Now sign convention for the spherical lens. So focal length, the focal length f is positive for the convex lens. For the convex lens the focal length should be positive, and for the concave lens focal length is negative. Okay, f is positive for convex lens and focal length f is negative for concave lens. Now lens formula, that is 1 upon V minus 1 upon U is equal to 1 upon F, where V is the image distance, U is the object distance, and F is the focal length. So the lens formula is 1 upon V minus 1 upon U is equal to 1 upon F. This is known as the lens formula. Now we discuss about the magnification. So what is the magnification? So it is the ratio of height of the image to the height of the object of a lens. It is known as the magnification F. The symbol of magnification is small m. M is magnification. So it is the ratio of height of the image to the height of the object. It is known as the magnification M. Let us consider the height of image is h less and height of the object is f. distance. So related to the magnetization M. So M is equal to HDS upon H. So V is the image distance and U is the object distance. Okay. So M is equal to image distance to the object distance. It is also magnification. So M is equal to HDS upon H equal to V upon U. Now power of the lens. It is the reciprocal of the focal length. It is the reciprocal of a focal length. It is known as the power of lens. Okay, reciprocal of the focal length. It is known as the power of lens. So power P is equal to 1 upon F. Reciprocal of focal length is 1 upon F. So P is equal to 1 upon F. It is known as the power of lens. In the reciprocal of focal length, it is known as power of lens. The SI unit of the power of lens, it is dioptre. Is known as dioptre. The SI unit of power of lens, it is dioptre. Okay. So here P is equal to 1 upon F. So power measured in dioptre, it is 1 dioptre. Focal length measured in meter. So 1 dioptre is equal to 1 upon N. Okay, right here 1. 1 dioptre equal to 1, 1 upon N. So reciprocal, that is 1. Okay, 1 dioptre is equal to 1 meter inverse. Okay, 1 dioptre is equal to 1 meter inverse. Like that. Power measured in dioptre. Focal length measured in meter. So 1 upon N. 1 dioptre is equal to 1 meter inverse. Now power of lens for the convex lens, it is positive. Power of lens for the convex lens, it should be positive. And power of concave lens, it should be negative. So let's take the two example here. If the lens prescribed by the doctor, the power that is plus 2.0 dioptre. Now plus sign. So plus sign, that is positive sign, power of convex, it is a convex lens. Okay, plus means positive means convex lens. Power of lens, that is convex lens, 2.0 dioptre. Then find the focal length of the given lens. We have to find out the focal length of convex lens. Why is convex lens? It is a positive sign. So as you know that the power of lens is equal to 1 upon F. Now power is given plus 2.0. So right here plus 2.0 dioptre 1 upon F. So F is equal to invert, that is 1 upon 2.0 plus. So 1 divided by 2. 1 divided by 2. So here 0.25 is 10. So 0.5 to 0.50, this also known, that is F is equal to plus 0.50 meter. Okay, the focal length of the convex lens, it is 0.50 meter. Okay, similarly another example we should take here. If the power of lens is -2.5 dioptre, if the power of lens is -2.5 dioptre, then find the focal length of the given lens. So as you note, the power of lens is equal to the reciprocal of the focal length, that is P is equal to 1 upon F. Power is given -2.5 dioptre. Minus sign is concave lens. Okay, power of concave lens is negative. So here negative sign, so it is a concave lens. So if the power of lens is -2.5 dioptre, so right, power of lens -2.5 dioptre, then find the focal length, F find out. Okay, so -2.5 is equal to 1 upon F. So F is equal to 1 upon -2.5. Okay, now for simplification, numerator and denominator. Okay. multiply and divide by 4. So F is equal to 1 4 = 4 minus 25 4 = 100 here point. So 10.0. So F is equal to minus 4/10. So focal length F is equal to minus 0.4 meter. Okay, minus 0.4 meter or minus 0.40 meter. So the focal length of the given diameter, that is minus 2.5 diameter, the focal length of the lens is minus 0.4 meter. It is the lens for concave lens, for concave lens, because it is a negative sign, so it is a concave lens. Okay.